Hey guys, Ralph here, and welcome to True Power Trumpet Fitness and Terrific, Terrific Thursday here in Connecticut. Anyway, you saw the thumbnail. It takes a bit of explanation. That is a quote from the movie Moneyball. If you haven't seen it and you like baseball, do yourself a favor. You can get it on demand for $3.99 now. And I'll explain in a minute. I have not played yet today. Guys, listen. All I've done is SFE, and if you are not doing SFE every day, number one, for your health, and number two, making it an integral part of your practice routine, it's like having a toolbox without a hammer. It's as simple as that. Guys, I need 10 bucks like I need a kick in the butt. I don't care about the money. Guys, it is a wonderful tool for you to have. Okay, let's see what we got. How's that for warm-up? Anyway, the first one through the wall always gets bloody. Always. That was the character played, character of John Henry, the owner of the Red Sox, saying to Billy Beane, but this is a character, played by Brad Pitt, about how he was getting slammed for his new Moneyball approach to baseball. Now, how many years later after that, everybody's doing it. He absolutely revolutionized the game. Revolutionized the game. And the problem is, all of a sudden, everybody's now doing Moneyball, and they still have more money than him. So he's got to come up with something else. And the only way he's going to do it is revolutionized through pitching, and I'm the only one that has that knowledge. Anyway, that's for a different video. But I see very, very common thread between that quote and Jerry and myself. Now, Jerry was the first one through the ball, and my Lord, did he get bloody. Why, as John Henry said, you are threatening people's livelihood. You are threatening people's way that they have made a living for years. Not that Jerry was anything resembling a threatening man. Quite the opposite. He was the sweetest person in the whole world. But he was telling the giants of the world that they were doing it wrong, and they could not deal with it. Now, many of the giants loved it. Jerry and I used to talk ad nauseum. If somebody walked in here right now and could blow me off the stand, just kill what I just did, kill it, tone, power, range, and nerves, I'm the first one to sit him down and say, what mouthpiece are you? Where's your tongue? And how much? The first one. I'm so excited about something like that. I'd be the first one to do it. These guys aren't like that. Jerry and I walk into the room and blow people off the stand, and what? Oh, no. It can't be done that way. That's not how you do it. You can't use that mouthpiece. Oh, because it threatens every single thing that they've ever said. Because if what I'm saying and Jerry was saying is right, that means what they've been saying their whole life is wrong. And they cannot get past that. And the worst, absolute, the worst guys for that are high school band directors and college professors with their PhD. Oh, no, that can't be right. Now, really top professional players are always looking for an edge. Wayne Bergeron loved what Jerry said. Chris Jaudice took lessons with him. Dominic Dereth. I remember back in the day, guys, Maurice Andre sent his son to Jerry. What else need be said? Armando Gatala, principal trumpet with the Boston Symphony, sent him dozens of students and studied with him himself. John Ware studied with him himself, sent him dozens of students. And when I studied with John Ware, he was asking me about chops and what Jerry thought of this, blah, 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 the new mouthpiece and all this. Guys, that's what great players do. Small little guys that can't play and are just hanging on to their little niche for dear life. Those are the ones that come out attacking. Oh, an idiot. Lou Soloff, Marvin Stamm, Alan Rubin. You really want to go down. These are the guys that studied with Jerry. Herb Smith, best chops everywhere this side of Bataillon. Guys, now, I'm the second one through the wall. I'm not getting nearly as bloody as Jerry got. I got little nicks all over me and all that sort of stuff. I can take it. But guys, the point is, like Moneyball, 10 years from now, everybody is going to be playing a 1SB and playing like this. Because why? It's right. It is absolutely right. Physiologically right, performance-wise, tone, power, range, endurance, it's right. Now, I will give his detractors this over the years. Even though he was right from the day he stepped foot in New York City and started playing Maria, you know, lying down doing scissor kicks. Ever since that day, okay, he has been light years ahead of everybody. But he admitted to himself and to me and to anybody that listened, it was not completely right. Okay? And I will say this, it was a work in progress for a good 40, 45 years. So I'm giving all the detractors a pass in that regard. And that it wasn't quite ready. It was superior to anything they were doing. No question about it. But it wasn't quite ready to go. And it wasn't till about 2 years ago, I lose track, when he came out with the 1SB, the piece de resistance, the cherry on the top of the sundae, that is what brought it all together. Guys, the 1SB with this pedagogy will give you anything you want. Unlimited double C's, less than a week after an enormous Lyme disease break. I could play a minor gig tonight, an orchestral gig tonight, a solo gig tonight. I barely practiced. I feel much better today. I'm going to practice as soon as I get this up. Guys, the first one through the wall is always bloody. Always. Jerry and I have taken those slings and arrows for you. There's nothing left, guys. It's there for you to embrace. It's there for you to take. You 90-year-old guys, there's no reason in the world you can't play double C's. You 15-year-old guys, there's no reason in the world you can't play double C's. And do it immediately. Anybody that tells you have to go 52 weeks or you have to do this, that, or, you know, if you're on a high C and it take you how many years to get to, don't know what they are talking about. There is no scientific data anywhere that backs up what they're saying. None. This is scientifically proven, physiologically proven, humanly proven. For the 2020s, by the year 2030, I'll be well into my 70s, playing better and stronger with more tone, power, range, endurance than I am now. And I'll tell you, worldwide, they'll be playing SF1SBs. It'll be the number one mouthpiece used and system used by everybody. Guys, you've got it now. You're going to be ahead of the curve. Embrace it. Get your double C and conquer the trumpet world with true power. Not the fake stuff, true power. Love you all.
Hey.